through school. And I also was a research subject several times. This was at the conference last year. But I've done much more invasive studies, like Tiffany was talking about, where they put in catheters and all kinds of crazy stuff. But anything for science. Okay. So just a summary of what helped most. Unfortunately, I think what helped most was actually time. Like Hannah was mentioning, a lot of teenagers who get POTS, they gradually better throughout their 20s. And now I'm 24 and I feel almost cured. And I think a lot of that was just time. A dairy-free diet helped me a lot, as well as medications in the short term, although I'm off almost all of my medications at this point. Also gradually increasing my cardio exercise and just activity in general. Currently, I'm not really on a cardio regimen, but I walk a lot. Like, I have this Fitbit. I've already walked, like, over 8,000 steps today, running back and forth for this conference. So just being as active as I could has helped. Also having those coping mechanisms and finding the motivation to push through my symptoms until they resolve. So finding ways to help others and keeping motivated to stay in school and have a goal in mind. So I used to tell people I feel 90% better, or I still have some days when I'm dizzy, but I'm mostly fine. But my new attitude is that I don't feel better 100%, but it doesn't stop me from doing anything. And also, the truth is my life is better now than it was before I had POTS. And a lot of that is the benefits of what's come out of having POTS. So this is like my climbing down a 12-story building. Being able to be involved in POTS research and presenting my work at conferences with my posters has been a great experience for me, and it's really ignited my passion for biomedical research. And I also get to be treated, like a colleague now by some of our POTS experts. So since I got involved in research, I've published 8 papers, and my brain fog one at the top has my brain fog paper at the top has been cited 13 times in the past 2 years, and I did this project while I was in college, while I was sick. I would lay in bed emailing people, going through these questionnaires, and so you can really do anything even while you're still sick. And now, I'm not currently studying POTS. I actually study this disease called peripheral vascular disease, and these patients can't walk at all. And the treatment for this is actually exercise as well. So it's actually similar to POTS in a lot of ways, and I have a lot of compassion for the patients I study, I think because I have POTS. I don't see them as lazy, because I know what they're going through, how hard it is to push through pain. So my current medications are mostly supplements. I have Provigil, one medication on the side, which I take a small dose of on days where I'm really symptomatic, but that's it right now. And so my bottom line here is that a full recovery from POTS, EDS, and QRE is possible. I graduated college. I'm now going into my 3rd year of graduate school. And I ran a 10K last year. And I'm actually a better runner than I ever was before I had POTS. In high school, I could barely run a mile. And there, I ran 6. I was also towards the end of the pack. Finishing that race, but at least I did it.